What's up YouTube and welcome to a new video. Now if you clicked on this thumbnail to watch the video, then you probably know that the McLaren 720S is notorious for its high depreciation rate and poor reliability. Now 6 months ago I showed you in this video over here how high the depreciation rate is and that the worst might be over for some cars. In today's video I will give you a market update and show you if my price forecast of the previous video made any sense. However, before we dive into the price changes, I will first show you today's market. Let's first figure out how today's 720S market relates to the other McLaren markets. You can see that we have the model year on the horizontal axis and the price on the vertical axis, and that each car for sale is displayed by a bubble. We have the 720S in red, the 650S in orange, the 570S in green, and the MP412C in blue. Now you can see that the 720S market is the second largest market, but also the most expensive one. The median price lays around $170,000 above the one for the 570S and 650S. So the price difference between the markets is huge. And on a side note, check also how close some of the 570S's are priced to the 650S. But that's perhaps something for a different video. We zoom in now to the 720S market. You're now looking at the same graph, but with only the 720S's included. Let me run you through some general numbers. As of today, there are 126 cars for sale and the median price for a 720S is $343,000. And as you can see from the graph, the median price varies a lot per model year. And this, of course, already reveals something about the depreciation. Now, if we split the market by roof type, then you can see that there are 82 Spiders for sale versus 44 coupes. And that almost all of the cars from model year 2020 are Spiders. If we look then at the final split, the one between the used and the new cars, then we can see that there are 56 new cars for sale versus 70 used cars. And have a look at the price difference between the new and the used cars in model year 2020. That price difference is quite scary. Used cars from model year 2020 have a median price which is around $50,000 lower than their new counterparts. But this makes perfect sense. In my previous video, I showed you that a 720S tends to lose $106,000 in its first year. So a drop of $50,000 is in line with that. Alright, it's time to figure out how much prices changed over the last 6 months. And we will build this up slowly. That means that we will first have a look at the changes in the price and the mileage distributions, and then investigate how different market segments changed. We will start with a change in the price distribution. In orange you can see today's market and in blue you can see the market 6 months ago. And as you can see, the shape of the price distributions is somewhat similar. Hence, the median price point didn't change. However, that doesn't mean that prices didn't change. If you look at the left-hand side of the distribution, then you can see that that appears to be so that prices changed at the lower end of the market. You can see that the orange price distribution moved towards the right-hand side, and that means that prices in today's market are slightly higher than that they were 6 months ago. And I will come back to this later because we will move on now to the mileage distribution. You can see here that we have again the two markets and that, just as with the price comparison, there is not so much change. The majority of the cars still have between 0 and 2000 miles. There are, however, a few more cars which have a relatively high mileage. So you are now up to date on the average price and mileage changes. And that means that it's time to dive into the details. We will namely investigate from a model year and a mileage perspective how much the price has changed, and where necessary we will drill down to the various market segments. Let's start with the model year perspective. You can see that we have still the model year on the horizontal axis and the price on the vertical axis, but that we have the current market now in blue and the market 6 months ago in orange. First, you can see that market supply shrunk. Now there are only 126 cars for sale versus 173 6 months ago. Oh, but before I forget, I need to mention that I cleaned up these markets slightly. That means that I only included new cars in model year 2020 and only included used cars in the other model years. This gives us a nice and clean depreciation curve. And speaking about that curve, we can see that it shifted slightly, but that the shape is more or less the same. Nevertheless, because of this shift, the average depreciation per year decreased slightly from $68,500 to $60,000. Alright, let's look into some numbers. If we start at model year 2020, then we can see that the median price point for new cars is the same. There simply is no difference. However, when we follow the depreciation curve downwards to the used cars, then we can see some significant price differences. We can see namely that the median price for model year 2019 is around $20,000 higher, and that this is around $12,000 for model year 2018 and 19. And who would have thought that a price increase for a McLaren 720S. It is then also so that at first it might seem that prices actually went up. But there might be other reasons for this price increase. And one of those reasons might be that the market composition is completely different for the two timestamps. For example, although unlikely, it can be so that the cars in today's market are all high-spec cars and that the cars 6 months ago were mostly low-spec cars. Furthermore, because supply decreased from 64 to 41 cars, it can be so that we are looking at an inaccurate representation of the market. Now, I will come back to these reasons at the end of the video. We will now continue to investigate if the price increase can result from a difference in mileage. But before we do that, if you like this video, I would like to ask you to support the channel by smashing that like button. Also, don't forget that you can request an analysis. Simply comment the name of the car for which you would like to see a video down below in the comment section. Once there are enough requests for a certain car, I will make a video about it. Remember then to subscribe and click on the notification bell so you get actually notified when your requested analysis goes live. Alright, let's continue now by looking at the price changes from a mileage perspective, and we will do that with the following graph. You can see that we have now the mileage on the horizontal axis instead of the model year, and that the price is still displayed on the vertical axis. And I only included the used cars in here. For the new cars, we saw that prices didn't change. Now, also in this graph, we can clearly see that the orange line lays above the blue line. And this means that for a car with a given mileage, you need to pay now more than you had to do 6 months ago. It is even so that the median price for a used car increased with almost $50,000. And this price increase is statistically confirmed. And that means that it is unlikely that the increase is the result of chance. Now, as you can see from the graph, the increase is mainly driven by the low mileage cars. For the higher mileage cars, the blue and the orange line are closer to each other. What is also interesting here is the size of the shaded area. It is clearly larger than that it was 6 months ago. And this means that the uncertainty in the market is larger as there is more price variation. Nevertheless, it is interesting to see that no single 720S is priced below the cheapest 720S 6 months ago. And this is quite an extraordinary observation. Now then, finally, this graph also tells us that the price increase is not the result of a change in the mileage. That would namely mean that the current cars would have a higher price because the median mileage would happen to be lower. But the median mileage is exactly the same. Let's take this now one step further and break this graph down even further, namely by model year. You can see that we have now a graph for model year 2018, 2019 and 2020. And with this breakdown, we can see now that the price increase happened for all model years. However, out of all of the price changes, the increase was the largest for model year 2019. For model year 2020, it is the smallest. You can then also see that there is a large group of cars which is priced in the blue shaded area. Therefore, I think it is fair to say that we can see the increase most clear for model year 2018 and 2019. Now, I also had to look at the same graph, but then split by roof type. But that showed that prices went up for both the Spiders and the Coupes. So I won't cover that anymore in this video. Alright, so the data shows that the price for a used 720S increased. And this is the opposite of what you might have expected. After all, the depreciation curve is very steep in the first years. So is there a possibility that the data we are looking at is somehow wrong? Well, maybe not wrong, but there are a few things which we need to keep in mind here. As I already mentioned before, it can be so that the market composition is different now than that it was before. Since market supply shrunk, we are looking now at a smaller part of the market. And that means that we could be missing the lower price level. It could be so, for example, that we only included the higher spec cars. But unfortunately, I have no way of checking this. From the other side though, the price increase is quite significant. Moreover, even though that the market is smaller, the chance that no single car is priced in the lower price segment is very small. And additional to this is that the used car market has been extremely strong. If you look at some of my more recent videos, then you would have seen that most used car prices remain stable and that also other cars went up in value slightly. The 720S market just might be another example of a very strong used car market. So I think we can conclude that over the last 6 months, prices at least didn't tumble further. And this is quite impressive for the 720S market. Now, do we have enough evidence to say that the prices increased? Not fully. But we also don't have enough evidence to falsify the price increase. And I realize that this sounds very much like an evading answer, something like a politician would give. However, if you are a long-term viewer of this channel, then you know that I like to make my claims based on data only. And with that, let's go back to some of the claims which I made in my previous video and figure out if they made any sense. First of all, I said that it was one of the best moments ever to buy a 720S. And based on the current price increase, that seems to hold. However, I also showed you that the forecasting model predicted a drop of around 10% for a 2018 720S. And as we just saw from the data, this prediction was simply wrong. Now, if this video encouraged you to purchase a 720S, bear in mind that McLaren offers a 3-year warranty period as standard. And this of course means that the 2017 cars are now out of warranty, something which you might not want for McLaren. You can of course get an extended warranty, but this will cost you. And with that, we arrived at the end of this video. Now, if you enjoyed this video, please remember to support the channel by smashing that like button. Also, don't forget to comment the name of the car for which you would like to see an analysis down below in the comment section. As always, a huge thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next week for a new video.